hope that you've had a great Thursday. We so enjoyed spending time with everyone last night with our Zoom call, our Instagram Live, and our Facebook Live. And just want to say thank you to so many of you that joined in last night. For the few that didn't get to join us last night, we certainly missed you. We certainly love being able to connect during this time of isolation. And we encourage you to do the same in your free time and with your family. Reach out to someone and say hello and stay connected with each other on a personal level. If you don't know me, I'm Pastor Chad. I'm the youth pastor at Christ Chapel Dublin. And since our time of isolation has begun, we've been doing a devotion series each day, and then we've been participating in the youth group at home.com live stream each Wednesday night. And so today will be day one of our discussion questions stemming from week four's live stream that happened last night. And if you didn't get to catch that, highly recommend you going over to youthgroupathome.com or the YM360 website and checking out week four's live stream. Pastor Andy gave us three specific points last night that we're going to drive into or delve a little bit deeper into this week as we look at our discussion questions. And if you didn't catch the three main points from last night, a life changed by Jesus means, point one, saying no to things. Point two, a life changed by Jesus means saying yes to things. And then the third point, a life changed by Jesus means saying, I love you. And so tonight we're going to delve into our question one for this week's discussion. And it's a big one. It's certainly one that I think is very, very appropriate for us to consider this week. If you don't know, this week is the Super Bowl of Christianity. This week is Easter. We've been celebrating resurrection time during our week here at home. It's Holy Week. And so we've been talking about Easter and looking at ways that we can still participate in Easter together as a family, even though we won't be at church and we won't be able to spend time with family face to face. And so our prayer is that this week, you've been taking some time and spending some time with the Lord and considering what this week really means and what Jesus really did for us this week. And so that leads us into the question of the day for Thursday. And it's a very big question. So it's one that I kind of want you to do in two phases. One, I want you to consider this question and I want you to write down immediately what you think on your answer. And then I want you to simmer on it until tomorrow. And then I want you to look at your answer from tonight. And then I want you to delve a little bit deeper into what God's revealing to you. And so here's the question. How has Jesus changed your life? It's a simple question, but yet a question that has a profound impact on your life if you truly consider what Jesus has done for you and how he has changed your life. It's no mistake that we're having this conversation during our Easter season, the time in which we celebrate the ultimate sacrifice that Jesus made, because Jesus came from heaven where he was already with God and the Holy Spirit in heaven. He chose to sacrifice his own life by coming to earth as a man, to feel our emotions, to feel what we feel, to be tempted in the way that we are tempted, and to live a life as we all live, dealing with all the things that come with being human. And yet, he did all of that. He endured the pain of the cross. He endured being abandoned by his friends. He endured all those things just so that he could die for our salvation. And so I think it's fitting that this week that we would start off our discussions this week considering how Jesus has changed our lives, because the ultimate question is, has he changed your life? And our prayer is that Jesus has changed your life. And if he has, the question is how? It's more than just a Sunday morning, go down to the altar and say a prayer, go to the baptism pool and be baptized. There's so much more to a life change that Jesus brings on than that. And those things are critically important. Those things are amazing. But there's so much more to our lives than just that one salvation moment. God intends for Jesus through what he's done on the cross and for what he's done through his word, that each and every day our life is changed in some way. And so tonight I want you to quickly consider how Jesus has changed your life, but then I want you to really let that simmer in your spirit. And I want you tomorrow morning, when you get up in the morning and you do your morning devotion, you really have some time on your hands, I want you to sit down and really consider how Jesus has changed your life. I promise you, many things will be revealed to you as you go through this process of considering this question. And our prayer is that A, you will realize how blessed you are, but B, you will consider maybe how much more you need to allow Jesus to change your life. I know for me personally, I've been a Christian for most of my life. I'm 42 years old. I've been a youth pastor for over 20 years now. And each and every day, I am reminded by life that I need to be changed by Jesus more and more every day. I need to constantly and consistently go before him in his word and in my prayer time so that he might renew my spirit and that the Chad flesh would die and that Jesus and the Holy Spirit would grow in me each and every day so that how I wake up in the morning will not be the same person that I go to bed at night as. God needs us to recognize that we need to change. He's provided the mechanism for change through Jesus. And so now it's just up to us with what we're going to do with the gifts and opportunities that he gives us. And so if you will, I'd like to pray with you tonight. I'd like for you to join with me in this time of prayer as we consider this question for Thursday. How has Jesus changed your life? If you will, let's bow and let's pray. Father God, I thank you so much for the opportunity to spend time together. God, I thank you for technology and for allowing us the ability to connect together in this time of isolation. And we can come together and consider your word, God, and how it speaks to our hearts and our lives. And how, God, you, through your Holy Spirit, can cause us to consider our lives. God, when we think about how you've changed our life, God, there's so many blessings that we can consider. There's so many things that you've done for us. But most importantly, God, you, through Jesus' sacrifice, Lord, you provided a way for us to be acceptable and lovable. And Lord, you provided the pathway and the way by which we could go to heaven one day. And so, God, my prayer is today that your Holy Spirit would come down. And as we consider this question, both in the short term and in the long term, God, that you would help us to really dig into how you've changed our lives. And God, in doing so, we could also consider how much more we need you to change our lives, how we need you to change our attitudes and our actions, things we say yes to and things we say no to, and ultimately how we treat those around us. God, I ask for you to just work in our lives and help us, God, to draw closer to you, that our flesh may be grow weaker, the spirit that you give inside of us would grow stronger, and that, God, you would be our guide through this time and through this process. God, I ask your hand to touch each and every family of every person watching this devotion, that, God, we would not waste this time you've given us, but, God, we would lean closer into you, God, and we would look to you for our guidance, our wisdom, and our strength. God, I love you, and I thank you. And I pray our celebration of your sacrifice this Easter would be greater and deeper than we've ever experienced. God, I love you and I thank you for all that you do for us. And it's in your holy and precious name I pray. Amen. I pray that you guys have a great evening. We love you. We miss you. We pray that you continue to dive into our devotion series. And we look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Love you guys. Have a great Thursday evening. This is my testimony.